Okay. Hello, students. So today we will discuss about the algorithm that is called midpoint circle drawing algorithm in computer graphics, right? So midpoint circle algorithm is very, very important. It mostly comes in the exam. Basically, sometimes the question asks, what is midpoint circle algorithm? You have to discuss the algorithm. Or sometime question comes, how to solve a question, how to draw a circle with the help of midpoint circle algorithm. So before drawing the circle, we have to understand what is a circle, what is a midpoint circle, and there are lots of things are there. So before starting the algorithm, we have to discuss the concepts of a circle. You must aware, in mathematics you already know, you have studied about the circle. This is a circle, x-axis, y-axis, and this is a radius of a circle, right? So in mathematics classes, in schools, you have read about how to draw a circle, what is the equation of a circle. There are two methods to draw a circle. The first method is called the polynomial method, right? In polynomial method, what was the formula? It will be x square plus y square is equal to r square, right? So you have to put the value of y and r, you can find out the value of x, or you can put the value of x and r, you have to find the value of y. Suppose I'm writing like here, r square minus y square, I can write like this. Suppose I find the value of x, it will be root of r square minus y square, you can write like this. But suppose I have to find the value of x by this method, it will be very, very complicated method, and it does not suitable in the computer graphics to draw a circle. So this method fails in the computer graphics. The second method, which you have studied in mathematics in your school time, that was a trigonometric method. Trigonometric method. What was the trigonometric method? Suppose here r is the radius and that is the angle theta. So what was the formula? You have read x is r cos theta, y is r sine theta. So based on the value of theta, you can find out the cos theta value and r, that is multiplied, and you can find the value of x and y. But that method is also very complicated in computer graphics, because we have to draw through the software. So this method is failed. That's why we move from the simplest method to the algorithmic method in computer graphics. It means we cannot use these method like polynomial method and trigonometric method to draw a circle. So we have to use the midpoint circle algorithm to draw a circle. And this algorithmic method is very, very easy to draw a circle. So let's move to this algorithm. Right? So here, come to here. This is the midpoint circle algorithm. We have to read one by one. The first step, what it says, input radius r. In question, already the radius is given, nothing else. The question is given, the radius is given, and you have to draw a circle, right? So input radius r and the center x, c, y, c. And center is given, it can be given or it cannot be given, clear? And obtain the first point on the circumference of the circle centered at origin x naught y naught is equal to 0 minus r. It means the radius is given, so we have to assume x naught means initial point, y naught is initial point. Means we can say that x or y, or we can say that x naught y naught, x is by default 0 and y is by default radius r, that is r. Clear? Second step is calculate the initial value of decision parameter. What is decision parameter? This is very, very important point. What is decision parameter? On the base of decision parameter, we have to check whether the point is inside the circle or outside the circle, or how to draw a circle. So the formula P is known as the decision parameter. Here I am taking a symbol P. You can take any symbol, you can take D, you can take any symbol. So here I am taking P. P is a decision symbol, which is 1.25 minus r. Clear? when you write this algorithm in software, then we have to take 1.25 minus r, but when we calculate it through numericals, after discussing this algorithm I will discuss the numerical. So for the sake of easy calculation, instead of 1.25 here I am taking p is equal to 1 minus r, so that our calculation will be more easy. It will not affect the points. It will there will be a effect after the decimal point. There will be no problem. So you can take during the calculation p is equal to 1 minus r. Now point number 3, totally and totally based on the point number 2. What is it? It says if point p is less than 0, means if the value of p is less than 0, what we have to do? We have to increment the value of x by 1. There is no change in y value, and after that the value of decision parameter will be this. Clear? Here if p is greater than equal to y, then there will be increment in x and decrement in y, and the value of decision parameter will be this. Clear? There will be a loop. You have to check again and again, means when p is suppose less than 0, x will be incremented, y will be same, and decision parameter formula is now this. Now again check, p is less than 0, greater than 0. Suppose p is greater than 0, then x incremented, y decremented, and p will be like this. You have to check again and again till now. Where we have to stop? You have to stop till this condition not come, means while x is less than or equal to, here while x is less than or equal to y, until while is when x is not less than equal to y, we have to check the condition, and when this condition came you have to stop, and you have to find out what will be the output. I will show during the numerical. You have to find out symmetrical point in other 7 octant. What is 7 octant? That I will discuss after the numerical, right? So this is the algorithm. It will be more clear to you through the example. So let's take one example. Suppose I am taking one example. Okay, just a minute. I am taking one example. Yes, write down, use midpoint circle algorithm to draw a circle having radius 10 units, right? Radius is given, that is 10 units. Clear? So now start. Here radius is given, that is 10. Okay. Now you have to find x naught y naught, that is x naught y naught. You have to find which is 0 comma r. Clear? So x naught y naught will be 0 comma 10. Can you write it like this? X naught will be 0 and y naught will be 10. Clear? Now here you have to find out the value of p, decision parameter. Now you have to find out the value of decision parameter, that is p is equal to 1 minus r, that is 1 minus 10. So what will be the value of p? Minus 9. So this is the step number 2. Clear? Now after taking the step number 2, here what we have to check? We have to come to the step number 3. Here we have to check whether p is greater than 0 or p is less than 0. Here p, which is minus 9, that is less than 0. Clear? So this condition will be true. P is less than 0, x will be incremented, there is a no change in y, and p will be p plus 2x plus 1. So we have to make a table, tabular form. It will be more clear to you. Like you can take a table here, you can say that the points here, you can take decision parameter p, and what will be the increment or decrement in the value of x and y. It will be more clear to you. At the point when the point will be P naught, it will be 0, the value of P is minus 9, clear, less than 0. So initially the value of x and y was 0 and 10. Now here, when P is less than 0, x will be incremented by 1, there is no change in y. So x will be incremented by 1, means 0 plus 1, 1, and no change in y, it will be 10. Clear? And after that, the formula of decision parameter is this. So the formula of decision parameter is P plus 2x plus 1. Now, this is a point number 2. So P will be, you have to take from here, P will be minus 9 plus 2 into x. What will be x? It will be now 1 plus 1. You have to find out the value of P. It will be minus 9 plus 3, P will be minus 6. Clear? From here, it will be, P will be minus 6. Clear? So here, at the first point, P will be minus 6. Now again, P is minus 6. You have to check which is less than 0. P is less than 0. Now come here. P is less than 0. So this condition will be true. So x is incremented, no change in y. Clear? So here, x will be incremented 2 and no change in y, that is 10. Clear? And the formula of decision parameter will be this. So formula is P is equal to P plus 2x plus 1. So P is equal to P. What was P? Minus 6 plus 2. X was 2 plus 1. P will be minus 6 plus 4 plus 1. P will be minus 1. So at point 2, P will be minus 1. Clear? P will be minus 1. Okay. Now again, up to how many steps we have to do? Until x is greater than or equal to y. Here 2 is less than 10. We have to take more steps. Again check, P is less than 1, right? Here P, which is 1, which is less than 0. So again, we have to move here. This condition is true. X is equal to x plus 1, y is y. Clear? P is less than 0. So at the point number 3, this is less than, here, this is less than 0. So x will be incremented and y will be same. Clear? And the formula will be now same. P is equal to P plus 2x plus 1. So P was minus 1 plus 2 into x, 3 plus 1. So P is minus 1 plus 3, 2s are 6 plus 1, 7. P will be 6 now. So at the point 3, P will be 6. At the point number 3, P will be 6 now. Clear? I have to rub it because space is not there. Okay. Now here again, come here. P is 6 now. Now here, P which is 6, that is greater than or equal to 0. So which condition is true? This one part, P is greater than or equal to 0. So here, now what is the condition? X will be incremented and Y, sir red. Kahan pe ruka? So X will be incremented and Y will be decremented. Clear? Okay, x will be incremented and y will be decremented. So here, x will be incremented 4, y will be decremented, it will be 9. But this is less than 0, so we have to take more steps. Now we have to take this one formula. P is equal to P plus 2x minus 2y plus 1. So P, what is P? P is 6 plus 2 into x. X will be 4. Minus 2 into y. Y is 9 plus 1. You have to calculate the value of P. 6 plus 8 minus 18 plus 1. It will be 14 minus 18. It will be minus 4 plus 1. So P is minus 3 now. So here P will be minus 3. So at the point number 4, P is minus 3. Now again check here, P which is minus 3, that is less than 0. Less than 0. So here again P is less than 0, so this condition is true. X will be incremented, no change in Y. So here X will be incremented 4 to 5, no change in Y. Clear? And the formula of decision parameter will be this. Now P is equal to P plus 2X plus 1. So P is equal to P is 5 plus 2 into X is 5 plus 1. So P will be 5 plus 10 plus 1. P will be 16. So here P will be P is minus 3. Now here P is minus 3. So after taking minus 3, P will be P plus 2x plus 1. So P is P is minus 3, not 5. P is minus 3 plus 2 into X is 5 plus 1. Here, minus 3 plus 5, 2 is 10 plus 1. So P is 11 minus 3, it will be 8. Clear? So here, P will be 8 now. Now, I am rubbing it here. So, P is 8. At the point 5, P is 8. Now, P is 8, which is greater than and equal to 0. Now, again check, greater than or equal to 0, it means this condition is true. X is incremented and Y is decremented. So, X is incremented, 6. Y is decremented, 8. But here also X is not greater than or equal to 0. So, we have to move further steps. So, greater than or equal to 0. So, this condition is true. We have to take this one step. This one done. Now, the decision parameter formula will be this. P is equal to P plus 2X minus 2Y plus 1. So, P is equal to P is 8 plus 2 into X is 6 minus 2 into Y is 8 plus 1. Calculate the value of P. 8 plus 12 minus 16 plus 1. It will be 20 minus 16, so P will be 5 here. What will be the value of P? P will be 5 here, right? So here P which is 5, that is greater than or equal to 0. So X will be incremented, Y will be decremented. So here P is 5, X is incremented, that is 7, and Y is decremented here, that is 7. So at this point, when X is greater than or equal to 5, you can stop here. Okay, so you can stop here when X is greater than or equal to Y, and after that, these are the points. These are the points of midpoint, and you can draw these points. Now, how you can draw these points? You can draw these points with the help of x-axis and y-axis. When you plot these points, 0, 10, 1, 10, 2, 10, 3, 10, and so, the output will be like this, only this one. Means the output will be an arc only, not the completely whole circle. Why not hold the whole circle? Why there is a only arc? The reason is that with the help of midpoint circle, you have to draw a small portion. In the next class, I will discuss this concept. Basically, in the circle, there is an octant symmetry. Just I am giving a small introduction. There is an octant symmetry. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Right? So, with the help of a circle algorithm, you have the output will be a small little arc type. And suppose the output will be only this portion. So, other 7 octant, you have to draw with the help of scan conversion method of circle. Right, so that's why this point is written. Determine symmetrical point in other 7 octants. Other 7 points will be determined with the help of scan conversion. So in the question, you have to use a algorithm use these steps and you have to draw an arc and stop. And in the next class I will discuss about the scan algorithm, how to scan convert a circle and how to draw a 7 octant. So that's all about the midpoint circle. I hope you enjoy.